But providing the right advice, whether it is personal or corporate investments, Prudent Corporate Advisory Services has managed to carve a niche for itself in the wealth management space. I caught up with its management in Ahmedabad earlier to understand what makes them a disruptor in the space and how they've managed to carve that name for themselves in such a short span of time. Listen.
Today, Prudent offers its services to more than 6.5 lakh investors through more than 14,000 IFAs. Prudent is headquartered at Ahmedabad and operates through 108 branches across 19 states in India and has a young and vibrant team of 950 plus employees.
Great having you here on the show. To really talk about the initial days of Prudent and what what the future is looking like for you. You're almost 20 years old, starting the year 2000, and you've seen several milestones, but let's start with the initial days. Very briefly, tell our viewers about, you know, the journey really behind starting of Prudent.
Thank you very much, Sunanda, to have us on this show. Let me start with the journey which I started in 2000. So basically, I'm a chartered accountant by profession, and I was working with an industry. But there was a passion of doing something which has been loved by me. So mutual fund industry has been very, very close to my heart because it's an industry where a lot of intellect has been involved. And hence, I always liked working with the industry. So when in 2000, I thought of starting my own profession, I chose this industry apart from being a practicing chartered accountant. But when I started, 2000 was having their own issues also because there has been a recency of dot-com crash which has happened, ICE stocks which has came for a meltdown, Ketan Parekh scam has been unearthed. So I've been also trying to settle. So I think first 2-3 years has been very, very tough. But by 2003, we reached an AUM of 100 crore. Mm-hmm. That was the first milestone. And I can tell you when we reached 100 crore, equity was only 7 crore. So people were not ready to invest in equity as an asset class. But with 100 crore, we opened first branch outside the Ahmedabad in Baroda. That has been where the journey has actually started taking off.
And one definite highlight has been you hitting the 20,000 crore AUM mark. Congratulations on that.
Thank you, Sunanda.
So what, you know, possibly has really helped you achieve that landmark?
So I can tell you 20,000 crore has been definitely a big, big sense of achievement of Prudent, which has achieved over a period of last 18 years. If I put you in the perspective of where we stand in the industry, so today in terms of retail number of transactions, we are fourth largest. Mm-hmm. In case of equity, we are sixth largest. And in case of total assets under management, we are fortunately part of top 10 asset managers of India. And if I want to credit this entire achievement, then let me tell you from a point of four P's.
Sure.
So first P would be my people, my team. Second important point I can tell you would be from the point of processes. So if you look at my core, say the vision and mission statement of the organization, we wanted to be the most preferred wealth manager of India for masses. Third important point would be the partner network. Today we have almost about 14,000 partners and they are the key for our success. And fourth and most important thing is the Pru IT, which is the backbone for us. And we have been very, very conscious of investing into technology from day one.
Okay, fair enough. We've been talking about your milestones, and one definite landmark for you has been the investment that you've received from TA Associates. Why perhaps was that necessary? If you can talk about what that experience has been like and how that has really been an innovation and disruption in your industry in terms of raising funds from someone like a TA Associates.
Prudent has been started by me as an individual, and from a family-driven organization, promoter-driven organization, you want to make it a more professional organization. So with TA coming in, we got independent directors. They are also on the board. We got Deloitte as an auditor. So now you are becoming very, very professional from the point of view of organization. Second most important thing is that we are a part of cyclical industry. Whenever there is a downturn which comes, that downturn might last for a pretty longer period of time. And today, I'm not a single guy who is handling the business. With us, there are 1,000 employees, 14,000 IFAs who are associated. So in case of a bear time, if the bear time lasts for a longer period of time, you need financial strength. And TA kind of a player will always give you a lot of financial muscles.
Okay. So even as we're talking about what the journey so far has been like for you, my last question is to do a little bit of crystal ball gazing and to say, both in the short term as well as the long term, both for yourself as well as for the industry, both for the company as well as for the industry, what perhaps is the growth trajectory looking like? What next for you?
So I think it's an important question. If I look at growth of an industry, let me look at from a top-down approach. So let us look at how the country looks at, first of all. So first, I look at from a 3C. So let us look at the country per se. And I feel that country is poised for, India is poised for a serious growth over a period of time. I think India is going to be the world's growth engine. So serious growth of next 5 years, 10 years, something which is very, very visible. So country looks for a good growth. There is no doubt about that. Second would be the category. So within the country, when the financialization is taking place, what is the positioning of the mutual fund as an industry? And I feel over a period of time, after the financialization, the investors' options are getting, I think, coming down very, very drastically. And now within that category, if you look at C, that means Prudent as a company. So Prudent as a company, I can tell you, because of a lot of changes which is happening, for us to sustain and grow phenomenally as a company, you need to have support from three pillars. One would be the manufacturers whose product you are selling. Second would be the IFA partners who are associated with us, and the comfort of client who are working with us.
Thanks for your
time. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Shirish, great to have you here on the show. And you know, we've got a big picture in terms of Prudent and really the work that is happening and some of the milestones you've achieved. One thing I definitely do want to talk about is how closely you work with IFAs and how the IFAs really are your distribution strength, if you can run us through that.
So today I would say that we are working with close to 14,000 plus IFAs. We provide them various tools to increase their business. Now, I would segregate all the facilities what we provide to them in five categories. One is a client acquisition. Second is a client servicing. Third, I would say, is how they can increase the productivity.
Sure.
Fourth is the branding. And fifth is the research. Now, these are the five main things which what we provide, help them grow their business. Mm-hmm. Now, let me cover the client acquisition part. Mm-hmm. Now, today, the biggest challenge for any IFA in the market is how to acquire the clients.
Sure.
Specifically, when you are new and you don't have the brand identity in the market, the biggest challenge is how to acquire the clients. At Prudent, we support them taking or conducting the client meets. Now, today, they would be knowing so many people in the market, but they don't have the know-how that how to communicate the product or how to communicate the investment revenues to them. So we help them that they can call people, call the investors, and we go and support them in terms of client acquisition. The bigger challenge is today you acquire the client, how to service the clients. Now, when you have more number of clients, servicing becomes more challenging. And if you provide better service, then you can grow the client base. Today, I would say that client servicing, we take the complete backend from the advisor, from the IFAs. Another challenge for them is how to increase their productivity. Now, today, they do the database, they do the business. We provide the various analytical tools. We analyze their business. We tell them that this is what is need to be done for the clients. Fourth, as I said, is the branding. Now, today, the biggest challenge for every individual is how to create a brand in the market. We help them create their own website. We provide them their own mobile application, which they can give to their clients so that their clients can log in through their website or through their mobile application.
Sure.
And the last point, as I said, is the research.
Okay.
It becomes difficult for an individual person to research so many schemes in the market. At Prudent, we provide them the ready-made infrastructure wherein we research the fund, we shortlist the funds, and we help them. Mm-hmm. If they want any specific reports or any particular schemes, that also we provide.
Sure. Okay. Let's also very quickly talk about Funds Bazaar, and that's also an innovation that you've launched in the market. What do you want our viewers to know about that?
First of all, the response to Funds Bazaar is very, very good by the advisors and the clients.
Okay.
Almost 2.5 years before we launched Funds Bazaar, and we already closed more than 2 lakh registration amongst Funds Bazaar. Funds Bazaar is a tool wherein we provide, it's a kind of, we call it a B2B2C, wherein we provide this facility to our advisors so that they can take the technology to their clients.
Sure.
Frequent regulatory changes, I would say, is a bigger challenge for us at Prudent. We have to adjust with every regulatory changes. So you can't make a very long-term plan. You have to keep on adjusting with the regulatory challenge. That is the bigger problem for us. Second is investor choices, investor taste is changing frequently. So we always believe that I think we should not miss on that particular part. So that is why I think we try to understand what our advisors want on a regular basis. And that is how we keep on upgrading our software,
sure,
our services and our offering. That is the biggest thing what we try to do at our end.
Okay. My last question to you then is where you're really seeing both Prudent as well as the industry headed. Let's say in the next 5 to 10 years, both a short term as well as a slightly long term view.
So we believe currently the mutual fund industry is close to 25 lakh crore.
Okay.
By 2025, we see the industry crossing 90 lakh crore to 100 lakh crore. In that space, if I look at today, Prudent, we are at 20,000 crore. If I look at my number where we would like to be at, by March 20, so I'm saying 1 year down the line, we see ourselves at 30,000 crores of assets. And by March 2022, we would like to cross minimum 50,000 crores of assets growth. To support that, I would say that today we are adding close to 400 IFAs every month. So if I look at my current strength of 40,000 IFAs, that keep on growing month on month. To achieve this goal of Prudent of reaching 50,000 crore by 2022, we are also planning to add around 25 to 30 branches in next 2 years.
Okay, great having you on the show. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
All right, that's our show tonight. If you have any feedback for us, here's how you get in. Leaders of Tomorrow at timesgroup.com is our email ID. On Twitter, I'm at Sunanda_J. Our official Twitter handle, LOT_ET Now. Leaders of Tomorrow on ET Now is our Facebook page. Thanks for watching. Have a good night.